Matilda, no. Don't eat the chocolate. Don't eat the chocolate or there'll be emails. This is a nightmare. Come on now, behave. This is why I absolutely love this bookshop. Even when they do pick up, it's done in true style. I love their window. I live opposite and I just think of all of them, this is the best door. So you can get a glimpse actually through there. See how lovely they are? It's got one of the best travel sections you will ever find because it's got this wonderful gallery you can walk around. Just how lovely and welcoming is this? And if you think this is when most bookshops would be making their money because of Christmas, so it's really important that we support them now. Order online, collect, whatever, but use, you know, your local bookshop. See how lovely they are? And they're just getting them all ready now. So nice to see that you're in here. No, not at all. So yeah, this goes up every Sunday. 25,000 followers I have, so yeah. You don't need me.
Hello.
How are you? I was wondering why I wasn't on film. I mean, good grief.
So this is, they're all lovely people, but this is a massive dog lover.
Are you?
Matilda, I still say you need a shop dog.
Oh, you don't have to convince me.
I have to convince everyone else.
Exactly.
I love this. I love the brass bell and everything. It's so lovely.
I love this. It makes me feel old fashioned.
No, I love it. I absolutely love it. Have a good week.
Take care.
See you soon.
Oh, they're wonderful. I really love it. Do I look a bit like a boiled egg? I think I do, don't I? So I'm heading into work. Oh my God, so sorry. This is what I want. If I was 40 years younger, so it's obviously based on Villanelle from Killing Eve. She made that style of dress very, very popular. And Kevin's, the shop's closed, but I mean, I would look utterly ridiculous. I mean, I think I have to realise my limitations, don't I? Anyway, going into work because George is producing and we've created a new feature on the show, which is dancing. George chooses the tracks and we dance every afternoon for one track, rock and roll, at 2:30. I've got 25,000 subscribers now.
Yeah, it's very snug on my head.
My friend Frankie knit this for me. This is an apology.
Oh, no, you don't need to.
No, I shouted at George. I'm not at right. You, I was venting my wrath. Wasn't
oh,
I?
Oh, God.
Actually, that light is brilliant. Look what this is how I'm getting. Look what I've just bought.
What is it? Oh.
I love a hottie.
What's wrong with Matilda?
No, Matilda's okay. But there's something about hot water bottles. I've always loved hot water bottles.
Can we just zoom in on the hat?
So I quite like a cold bed.
You look like robbing a bank.
Of all the hats, I wear this one more than all the others. But gosh, this lighting's fantastic.
Nice, isn't it? We just figured it out. That's why we're in here.
Look, ever so short.
This is Inside Out.
Yeah, Inside Out, which is their office.
Did you see? Okay, that's such a boring tour, but anyway.
No, but I'm standing on my tiptoes. This is where, you know, all the little documentaries I do on Radio 1, on BBC One.
Radio
and
1.
And in fact, I don't do them anymore because there aren't any, but this is the Inside Out office. Mm.
Yeah, and this is where we've been banished. This has been banished because there's no desks at work.
Do you want to see a picture of me with the Inside Out team on my room?
Go on, take them. Okay, I'll follow you.
Just follow me.
Well, I can't really see that. I can't actually see the screen on here, but. Okay, let me flip this
room.
Down.
Ooh. In
Marylebone. Where? Oh, here.
Black and white. I'm in a cowboy hat.
You're going to point everyone out.
So this is our dancing. Here's Patrice. This is Patrice, everybody who works on the show. She's new to the show and look at her move. Go, Patrice, go. There's George pretending to work. This is where they work. got swing back legs.
Oh, I love learning the swing back.
Wow. So the shops in Marylebone, the ones that are open for essential shopping, are incredibly exclusive and, let's face it, expensive. There is Waitrose around the corner, which is where I end up going. But I have always, as much as I love Marylebone High Street, I have always envied the people that live in an area where there are pound shops, places that you can get a real bargain and that you can find stuff that elsewhere you pay a fortune for. So I have a surprise. There is a company that reached out to me that are friendly, local, if you live in London, but they actually deliver all over the country. But they're a London company. And I'm a London girl, which is why I wanted to point it out. And they reached out to me and said, listen, do you fancy collaborating and doing a piece on us? And I would never, ever, ever do anything like this about grocery shopping, because it's nothing that really interests me, until I looked at their website. So have a look at this. Hello, Matilda, good morning. Right. So, as I was saying, I live in a very zhuzhy part of London, and you know, my choice of shopping, economy shopping, is quite limited. There are very few bargains to be found on Marylebone High Street, and I always envy people who lived with pound shops and, you know, those places where you get really sort of quirky little gifts, stocking fillers and all that sort of thing. Anyway, because I'm going on, and people always say, no, Joe, you love your luxury brands. This company called Cherries, hence have a bite of the cherry or cherry on top, whatever I'm going to choose to call this vlog. They contacted me and said, okay, if you're finding it difficult to find economy stuff and quirky pound land type stuff, why don't you work with us? And we will send you a load of stuff that we think you'll enjoy using. And that is what they've done. So, I am working with Cherries, which is RRYZ. They are, I think, they're like a little family firm. So they're a London company, but they deliver all over the country. So wherever you're following me, wherever you're living, they will deliver to you all over the country. And they're just, first of all, they're very camp, very cheap, and very accessible. So, you know, since I've joined them, you get these emails going, Linda recommends this for Christmas. Anyway, enough waffle. In fact, there's dog stuff on here as well, if you go to their website. What they're offering, oh, let me just show you what I ordered, first of all. You get it in a box, it's a next day delivery. There's discount for key workers and a discount for students. But it arrives in a box with, I love this cherry tissue paper. There is nothing, I don't think I have ordered anything over a couple of quid. So let me just show you, and this is nostalgia as well as anything. Walnut whorls, I think these were a pound. My mum, so first of all, my mum, this is what I got for my mum. She loves Whispers, she loves walnut whorls. And all this confectionery is very nostalgic. There is even, do you remember these? Tea cakes. These are lovely little gifts for Christmas. Lovely little gifts for yourself. For my mum, she will absolutely love this. And I think you need to go to the website. There is nothing, none of those are over a quid. I think they're about 60p each. But then you get stuff. So when I was talking about candles, oh gosh, Matilda, you're not to eat that chocolate. Don't worry, she won't. Lots of you said you loved a Yankee candle because I was a couple of blogs ago talking about candles that cost hundreds of pounds. Guess what? You can order from Cherries Yankee candles, 3 for probably under a pound. I have not got the price list here because I'm telling you, none of this is going to cost you much indeed. This is the sort of thing that is a real bargain. So Zoflora, all this disinfectant stuff, sanitizing stuff, Matilda, that we're using. I'm getting through buckets load of this during this pandemic. All of this, so Zoflora is possibly my favourite scented. I'm going to put these away because I know you're going to worry about Matilda eating chocolate. I promise you she won't. Zoflora is one of the most expensive but beautifully scented disinfectants. This, under a pound. Check it out. Can't remember, I think it's about 60p. Oh my gosh, when I talk about nostalgia, Angel Delight, I used to come home from school, eat. So it's, what I say, it's camp, it's accessible. There is 20% off for all of you if you join the app, and I'll explain that in a moment. I really want some starlights for my new apartment. Again, I can never find these on the high street because I don't live near a pound shop. I think these are a quid, maybe less, not sure. Oh my gosh, do you remember Jazzles chocolate with hundreds of thousands? Yes, Matilda. Again, wonderful nostalgia confectionery, all under a quid. But the quirky things, body scrubs. So things like body scrubs, I will, if I'm not putting it on my face, I will use economy scrubs. And these are the tea tree, and this one, this is aloe vera. So two very cheap body scrubs. You can use those every single day. Eat it up, it's not gonna cost you a fortune. And see what I mean about how eclectic all this stuff is? Their website is fascinating because they do beauty, they do household, they do groceries, and then they do these quirky things. So if you've watched me making my soup in the past, I didn't have a chopping board for ages. And I've inherited this chopping board and I don't really want to use someone else's. So this is a vegetable chopper. You know, you put the onion and all the veg, sweet potato, whatever, in this without it sort of spreading all over, flying all over the kitchen. So this is probably the most expensive thing I've got. And I think it's about 3 quid. Check that out, vegetable chopper. Other things, notepads. I use endless notepads for work. Lovely, lovely stationery, love stationery, often costs a fortune, this doesn't. And when I say quirky things, sunglass wipes for my sunglasses and my glasses that I pretend I don't need. And look at this. So someone's been using my mum's bin, and I said to her, you need to put the house number on it. Wheelie bin numbers that you can stick on your bin. I could go on and on, but I won't. So, yes, I have collaborated with Cherries because they are fun, they are camp, they are incredibly cheap, they're truly accessible, and they're just, I just think, why not? For Christmas, all of this stuff, imagine sending somebody in the post some Zoflora and some nostalgia tea cakes. For me, perfect Christmas present. All you have to do, Matilda, do you want to play with this? All you have to do is follow the link and you will get 20% off your first order on the app. So this only applies to the app. I'm gonna leave the link to the app so you can shop on your phone, whatever. I'll leave the link below and get shopping. Happy shopping. I bet you never thought I'd be doing economy shopping, did you? And Matilda, they have actually got dog treats as well, so maybe I should order some of those. I just wanted to bring you here, A, because it's the most beautiful morning, and I'm not even in a coat, and the sun is shining on my face through these trees. This is Manchester Square in Marylebone, and this is the very famous Wallace Collection. It's possibly my favourite museum in London. It has the Smiling Cavalier, and it also has the painting The Girl on a Swing that you'll often see on chocolate boxes and biscuit tins. It's free to go in, although, you know, they do take donations. The reason I'm talking about it today is, as with every other museum in London, it is closed. And we are doing a piece today on the plight of museums all over the country, but particularly because my radio show is in London, the plight of London museums, because they are really suffering at the moment because they rely on our footfall. And as you can see, you can book tickets for the Wallace Collection online, but they have absolutely no idea when they're going to reopen. So I'd love to know your favourite museums, wherever you live, actually, wherever you live. Leave a comment below, because we need to flag them up and we need to support them as best we can. Maybe one of the best Christmas presents you could give someone is, I don't know, a ticket to a museum or an art gallery. Even if you just send it via an attachment, it will be something for them to be able to use when we eventually get out of all this. Gosh, it's a beautiful day. This is Manchester Square. By the way, gosh, get out of the sun. The very first Beatles Apple studio was over there in that corner, I think in the 60s. That's where I'm going to finish the vlog this week. And when I was just looking at that last clip in Manchester Square, I realised all the drilling has come back, hasn't it? London is slowly getting back to the noisy, polluted, wonderful city that it is. And I do urge you to support those museums. We did a whole show, actually, on all the little independent museums. Most of them rely on us for their funding. When we do eventually get back to being able to go out to venues, I think, as well as the theatres, the museums and the galleries need our support. Anyway, I hope you enjoyed my budget shopping. I suppose that was a way of saying, I know you always accuse me of buying things that are so expensive. Well, Cherries really is affordable. And if you use their app, and if you put in JoeGood20 for the first shopping, you will get 20% off, which is extraordinary, really. Because as I say, there's not a great deal over £4 on the whole website. That's it. Matilda did not eat any chocolate. I know that I'll get comments about that. Leave comments about your favourite museums, because we can all recommend places. Leave them in the comments. I love your comments. I really love them. And I spend most of Sunday afternoon reading them. Hopefully you do too. Please subscribe. Please give us a thumbs up. 25,000. Thank you, everybody. I didn't thank you. 25,000 I am now. And you know, you really pushed on last weekend when I was begging. So thank you. See you Wednesday for the midweek vlog. Have a great weekend. Bye. I'm walking. Yeah, the knee, and I'm talking.